Right, welcome back to Story Time with Nee. It's been a while, but there's been a lot going on over here. So, I suppose first thing off, I'd like to dedicate this one to my Nana Dodo, to the memory of her, and as well to my little sister Evie over in Australia at the moment. And, it's been real hard without you, Evie, and it's been real hard trying to connect properly, so, yeah, I love you. oh, here we go, I've been here already. I might get a little weepy during this, but we'll see how we go. So, I'm going to read out a poem called Breath that Evie wrote and I read out at Nana's funeral. Like I said, Evie couldn't be here. And I want to send this to you, Evie, and tribute that little way. Right. Breath. They say to focus on the breath, the rhythmic remedy to anxiety and stress, a calming opportunity to allow us meditate, inhaling and exhaling to attain the present state. Doesn't seem right that this breath has left your chest, though it's actually been a strenuous labour, a source of stress. So the focus now must be on what your breath meant, the enriching oxygen you exuded wherever you went. Consistent exhales of humour, outbursts of song and dance, pumping laughter into the atmosphere at every possible chance. No filthy joke was left unshared, no compliment left unheard. Your personality and energy immediately ignited smiles from the doctor's office to supermarket aisles, ever ready with a quip, a quick wit, and if we didn't laugh loud enough, do you not get it? We got to see that amazing things come in small spirited packages. Our Nana Dodo, our little grandma. Our air is fuller for the joy you breathed into it near and far. Oh. Now, when I focus on the breath, I don't want to be present nor to meditate, but remember all you gave us to celebrate. The gift and pride of your inimitable presence, the giddy giggles, encouragement, and unending support, the unique you that our hearts have on record. The breath of you breathes strong and steady. It will forever be at the ready. In the lungs of our memory, in moments, stories and conversation, it will always go on, go on, go on. Whew. And that's not far off how I did it at that, but I think I was a bit more of a mess then. So, thank you for those beautiful words, Evie, and miss you. And now, just to... Ugh! Let's see how far I can maintain this. And the other thing I wanted to do on this little video is probably gonna crucify me, but read the Little Match Girl. Little Match Girl, yeah. Hans Christian Andersen story. And so Nana did a little story time of her own. She recorded herself reading this into a tape recorder years ago in Donegal, and one of the neighbours came around and liked it so much that the tape disappeared. So yeah, we were talking about maybe doing a story time, but ran out of time really. So I'd like to dedicate this to her. It was cold in the small, cramped attic of the tenement where a family of five children was at work making artificial flowers. The wind whistled through the room, try as they might to stuff the biggest cracks with rags and straw. One of the children, who had an especially graceful way about her, was sent out to sell flowers and matches in the city. It was late in the wintry afternoon of New Year's Eve as the poor little girl walked along the icy streets. She had had slippers on when she left home, but they were not much good, for they were so huge. They had been last worn by her mother, and they fell off the girl's feet when she was running across the avenue to avoid an automobile and a carriage that had nearly collided. So the poor little girl went on with nothing but torn stockings on her numb feet. She carried a quantity of matches in a tray and the flowers in a basket. As she trudged along, she marvelled at the many wonderful things for sale, things that the little girl could never have imagined. And there was a most delicious odour of roast goose on the streets, for it was New Year's Eve. She could not forget that. Nobody had bought anything from her as the afternoon turned into evening. Nobody had even given her a coin. The child was hungry and trembling from the bitter cold, and she looked the picture of misery. The little girl longed to go home, but she could not. She had not sold any of her matches or flowers. Her father would beat her. Besides, it was almost as cold at home as it was here. She walked on until she found a corner that seemed to offer protection from the wind, but she was colder than ever. Her little hands were stiff. Her little hands and feet were almost stiff with cold. She thought perhaps a match would do some good. But did she dare take one from the tray and strike it on the wall to warm her fingers? She pulled one out, and with a "shh," it blazed into life. It burned with a bright, clear flame, just like a little candle, when she held her hand around it. It gave off a very strange light, too. It seemed to the little girl that she was sitting in front of a big stove with polished brass feet and handles. There was a splendid fire blazing in it and warming her so beautifully, but just as she was stretching her feet to warm them, the blaze went out, the stove vanished, and she was left sitting with the end of the burnt out match in her hand. She struck a new one. It burned. It blazed up, and where the light fell, the wall became transparent. And she saw a marvellous feast spread out before her. The table was spread with a white cloth and pretty china. A roast goose stuffed with apples and chestnuts was steaming on it. There was another table filled with cookies and desserts of all kinds. The little girl's mouth watered as she gazed at these delicacies. The match went out, and there was nothing to be seen but the bare brick wall. Again, she lit another. This time, she was sitting next to a lovely Christmas tree, surrounded by beautiful clothes and toys, all the things she'd only seen in shop windows. Thousands of lighted candles gleamed upon the tree's branches. The little girl stretched out both her hands towards them, then out went the match. The Christmas candles rose higher and higher, till she saw that there were only the twinkling stars. One of them fell and made a bright streak of light across the sky. Someone is dying, thought the little girl, for her old grandmother, the only person who had ever been kind to her, used to say, "When a star falls, a soul is going up to God." Now she struck another match against the wall, and this time it was her grandmother who appeared in the circle of flame. She saw her quite clearly and distinctly, looking so gentle and loving. She lit still another, and this time she was with her grandmother, just as they'd been so many times before. How real it all seemed to be. "Grandmother," cried the lonely child, "oh, do take me with you. I know you will vanish when the match goes out. You will vanish like the warm stove, the delicious goose, and the beautiful Christmas tree." She hastily struck a whole bunch of matches because she did so long to keep her grandmother with her. The light of the matches made it as bright as day. Grandmother had never before looked so big or so beautiful. She lifted the little girl into her arms, and they soared in a halo of light and joy, far, far above the earth, where there was no more cold, no hunger, no pain, for they were with God. In the cold morning light, the poor little girl sat there in the corner with a smile on her face. Dead. Frozen to death on the last night of the old year. When the people of the city finally arose on New Year's Day, they discovered the little body still sitting with the ends of the burnt out matches in her hand. The flowers had been scattered by the frigid night wind across the sidewalk and into the street. She must have tried to warm herself, some said. But no one imagined what beautiful visions she had seen, nor into what glory she had entered with her grandmother in the new year. Well, that's just one of those little things I had to do. It's kind of why there's been a bit of a break. Because I think this is, yeah, this is as good as that version's going to get. Unless we wait months or years or something, and even then. But, yeah. So love to all of my family, overseas or just in other parts of the country. It's an awful loss. I miss her. But anyway. Yeah. So that was, I suppose, a little story time with me special. Regular programming will continue. Yeah. Take care, everyone. Look after each other.